mark this pivot point P3, P2, P1 and P0. Once this is done, you can draw the arcs which gives the probable locations along which the roller can move, like this, from each of these points, like this. Of course, okay, don't have to draw an arc for zero, because finally it settles down at zero. After 6-6 dash, so you have the next 20 degree, it goes to 5-5 dash. So for this, you take the length of this, like this. The accuracy is not a matter. So from 5-5 dash, like this, and similarly 4-4 dash. And similarly 3-3 dash. Similarly 3-3 dash, and then 2 dash and 1 dash, then we can draw the laurels. Once all these points have been located, then you can mark these points as 5 dash. This is 4 dash, this is 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, of course this is 0, no lift. Then through these points, keeping the compass at these points, we will try to draw the rollers. So here, keeping the constant radius of 10, which is the roller circle radius, you draw arcs through each of these points, and of course at zero it will be, the roller will be here because there's no lift. So this is not easy to draw small rollers, very difficult. So try to complete these rollers, and once these rollers are done, to lift the rollers by this height, the cam profile should, the arc that you are trying to draw, which is the cam profile, should go tangentially through all these arcs of the roller, and it should go and meet the base circle. So out of this 360 degree, the first 120 degree is rise, the next 120 degree is fall or descent, the next remaining degrees is no lift. So this is dwell at the lowest position. So this is how you complete the problem given on oscillating follower. Here it almost takes around 45 minutes to 1 hour, even if you try to do it fast. So you can do it, you can actually speed up the process in two ways. The ways are, like when you're trying to mark these positions, since the heights are the same here, since the heights for 1-1 dash here and 1-1 dash here is the same, if you marked all these points at once, then you can mark 1-1 dash here and 1-1 dash here, like this. And also, the other mistake I made is, of course it's not a mistake, it's a, people do it that way to try to save the problem. They first try to take the angle, so they will try to take this, first, after drawing the roller center and the first pivot point, from here, they will mark the angles first, like this, for the first 20 degree, 40 degree, like this. So these angles are actually 20, 40, 60, like this, they will try to mark. And then, So they will try to take this as zero, and then they will try to mark these points like this. And once this is done, once this is located, from this point they will actually try to take this length of the lever like this, and then draw an arc like this, draw an arc which actually passes through this point. So in that way you'll be saving a lot of time in trying to locate this. So it will save a lot of time. Of course people have different ways of trying to do it. So in this way you can actually start like this. So first locate this points, and then you can locate one. Instead of actually locating 1, 2, 3, 4 at angles of 1, 20, 40 and 60, you can locate these angles as P1, P2 at 20, 40, 60 like this. Then from here, then since the lever length is long, then you can start drawing it here. Where it starts at the prime circle, there you can mark it as 1. From here you can mark it as 2. And that actually saves around almost around 3 to 4 minutes. So I should have actually done that way to save a lot of time. So I will actually post one more video which actually would teach you trying to solve in that way. Okay guys, this is a time when we have got corona pandemic, and people have their own issues, not able to connect to the internet, or maybe like you don't have instruments at home. So try to do something to come out of this. So this is a time where we have to learn in spite of this pandemic. The corona may continue for still longer. So April 15th was the date of the lockdown. So until then, so it may continue even after that. So I request you to solve these numericals and scan this and upload onto maybe the Google Classroom, or you can send it to my email ID, mbnacademics@gmail.com. Thank you guys.